Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name's Paul. Today we're going to be having a look at what is in this brown box. It is another Ubiquiti product. It is the Ubiquiti RPS, so the redundant power system. I'm not going to give you a big technical overview. We're going to show you what you've got in the box. We'll talk a little bit about it as we go along. So this is the unit itself, which I'll talk to you about in a moment. You are going to get a get started guide. Probably as small as you can be. You are also going to get set of screws and lugs for your rack and to be able to mount the two rack ears that you get onto the unit itself. There you go. And you are also going to get one RPS cable. So this is probably just over a meter long. Just show you the connectors up there for reference so you can see those and the end of it itself. All right, so what is the RPS? Well, the key thing in this is the RPS is not a UPS, right? This is not an uninterruptible power supply. This is a redundant power supply. With a UPS, it's got a battery in it. The idea is obviously if you lose power, the device, the UPS itself keeps providing power to all of your equipment. That is not what the Ubiquiti RPS is. The Ubiquiti RPS is there to provide a second lot of power in case your main power supply fails or your main power feed fails. So let's have a look at the unit and I'll maybe fill those dots together for you or even join those dots. So this is the front of the unit. Let me lift that up there so you can see. Traditional with like all of the Pro series, you've got these slots across the top here, which is your air intake. And we'll spin it around in a moment in, so you can have a look at the back. We've got our small LCD screen, touch screen up here, so we can see some of the status, reboot it, a few other bits and pieces. We have got our 1 gig Ethernet connection with a reset switch. So this is obviously fully joinable to your Unifi cloud controller, your cloud key, or your UDM Pro, whatever you're managing it in. So obviously that's why you need that side of things. Then on the back, all right, so we have our single power in on this side. We obviously have our cooling fans for sucking the air through that we saw before, and we have six RPS panels or connectors there. So there's a light indicator, maybe I can hold that up. There's a light indicator by each of them to show you when it is active. So if we just take off one of these covers, they're not always the easiest to take off. You just get a blank hole there. Then we would take our RPS cable, which is this, and we would actually plug this in and through into the slot. And then we would plug this into our other device that accepts RPS, which is basically the Pro series at this moment in time. So that's the USW Pro switches and the UDM Pro. So what is the difference? Or how would I use this? This unit here, as you can see, has one power in. If I was using this, this would be connected to one power circuit. Maybe that would be your UPS bank. Maybe it would be a different spur. Or a different tripped circuit. And then on the back of your actual device itself, say let's say it would be the UDM Pro, then that would be connected into another power source. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna run our RPS cable between both devices. What happens then? This unit itself is gonna sense the power and status of your other device and the power that's going into it. It's also gonna be there sitting there standby power source. If your main power supply actually in the unit physically fails, or that circuit trips or it loses power, then as long as this unit has power, it will drop its power from here straight to the unit. The unit that it's connected to, be a switch or the UDM Pro, won't turn itself off. It will continue running. This has 950 watts of capable power. So you do need to be aware it has six slots here on the back. So it can power six units. But obviously, if you've got the USW Pro 48 PoE, that's around about 750 watts already. So you're going to need to be careful to what devices you connect to this So there is enough residual power if all of them were to lose power at the same time. So hopefully that's been a good look at that. It is different to a UPS, but hopefully get the idea of what it's there for. Do head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got loads more box openings on wireless networking and firewall devices. We've got how-to guides, how to configure your network for Unifi products, how to do stuff with Unifi Protect. So stay subscribed and up to date, and hopefully that'll be useful. And this was the Ubiquiti RPS.